possess the land. Now is the time to take the kingdom. Rise up, be strong at God's command.
Because they were inspired with the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
These choruses were written during a church service.
Yeah.
When the ministry would be up speaking. And this right here has got the Bible all over it.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
It, now is the time to take the kingdom. Amen. Now what that's referring to, at the example that was given in the Old Testament.
Yeah.
When Joshua was getting those men ready and women ready to go across.
Yes.
That wasn't, they didn't, that wasn't the Red Sea.
No.
That was the Jordan.
Yeah.
You know, the Jordan is a muddy water, muddy river.
Yes.
Very muddy.
Yes.
Very, yeah. And that represents your fleshly nature.
Yes.
Now there's a kingdom to get into. There's a kingdom to take. You know, that kingdom, when the Lord spoke to Joshua, he said, there's ites in the land.
Yes.
There's all kinds of ites. And you know, we're not going to get into that, but each one of those represents a work of the flesh.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
And that was in that kingdom, but yet it was his land. It was their land that God was giving them. Well, God has given us a land to inherit.
Yes,
a spiritual land.
Yes.
Now there's ites in the land, but he's going to help us to overcome.
Yes, he is.
Going to help us to overcome all them fleshly traits that are in us, to where the full kingdom of God can reign in our hearts and in our lives. Now it says, now is the time to hear the trumpet. How many heard a trumpet tonight? I heard a trumpet. You know what a trumpet is? A trumpet. The trumpeter is the man of God.
Yes.
And when the Holy Ghost takes a hold of him, then you're not hearing his words, but you're hearing the sound of a trumpet. How many heard the sound of a trumpet tonight?
Yes.
When Brother Jerry got up, I heard the sound of a trumpet. How many heard the sound of a trumpet? Well, that trumpet, and the message is that is in this day right now, overcome yourself. I want to possess the land.
Yes,
but I've got to overcome myself.
Overcome yourself.
And how can I do it? Oh, somebody said, you'll never be able to overcome yourself. Yeah, you know, God has mercy and God has grace.
Oh, yeah.
Well, let me tell you something. You can.
Yes.
And if you walk in the light as he is in the light.
Amen.
Remember that scripture?
Yep.
You walk in the light as he is in the light. He's in the light.
Amen.
I want to go where he's at.
Yes.
So I'm going to walk in the light. What am I? What light is that? What he's talking about? The light of the gospel.
Amen.
You walk in the light of the gospel as he is in the light.
Yes. Amen.
How many can remember the rest of that verse? Pardon me? Somebody started to say, you'll have fellowship one with another. Who's that fellowship with? That's with Jesus.
Yes.
You and Jesus. Now, we'll have fellowship, but what's more important is the fellowship between me and Jesus. And when it starts to develop, and you're walking in the same aspect of following in the fellowship with Christ, guess what that's going to do? That's going to make us one. And we're going to walk in this wonderful atmosphere that we feel right now. God has been so gloriously here today.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Sister Laurel, I hope you come back soon. Soon. And I know you are. God's already told me you're coming back. Yep, she's coming back.
Praise God.
Praise the Lord.
She's coming back. You know why? Because she said she would.
She's coming back again.
He's coming back again. We sing that about Jesus. He's coming back. He's coming back. How does it go again?
Praise his holy name.
Coming back again.
He's coming back
again. Praise the Lord. Amen. We're glad for each one that have been here. And then, Jessica, God bless you for being here.
Honor your wife.
Pardon me?
Nothing.
Jessica, we're glad for her being here and being present with us in the service. And we pray that you'll come back again. Come back again. Now, is this the daughter of the ones that I married, sister?
No, this is my oldest son's daughter.
Oldest son's daughter, all right. So we're sure glad to have her with us. And let's pray for the family, that God will help them and draw them closer into the work of the Lord, and the Lord can bless. All right, I don't know of any other areas that we need to cover. I do want to have a breakfast with the brethren, and I don't know what day would be best for us. Through the week, it's almost impossible. Everybody working on jobs and doing, but I think we'll pray about it, and I'd like to have breakfast with the brethren sometime. Just the brethren. Sorry, sisters. Just the brethren. And you'll just have to do your thing, you know. But we're glad. And they already do. These sisters work together. You know, somebody said, well, I'm not used to these having to work. Where are the men? Where are they at? Well, you know what? This church, there's neither male nor female in Christ. So if there's neither male nor female in Christ, that means everybody works, right?
Amen.
And God bless you. He said, well, I don't know what to do. Just come on. Come on. We'll direct
you. Find something for you.
There's plenty to do. God bless all of you. And what an announcement. I can't remember any. I already did that, dear.
I know. Other than that, I don't know.
All right. Good.